Hey there, lovely people of YouTube. Welcome back to the channel. My name is Ajay. I'm a doctor from Bangalore, India. Diwali, or how we call it here, Deepavali, the festival of lights, sweets, crackers, and fun is here. It's one of my favorite times of the year and could be yours too. So in this video, let's talk about a few things that you should be doing and a few things you shouldn't be doing to have a much safer and happier Diwali. And no, don't worry, I'm not going to be telling you to skip sweets. I mean, if you don't have sweets on Diwali, when else will you? And in the situation we are in, sweets could make us feel a bit better as long as we do it in moderation. But of course, if you're diabetic, skip the regular sweets and go for safer options. We'll discuss all that. Now, I did say that Diwali is one of my favorite parts of the year, but it is also the time I dread going to the hospitals because of all the injuries I see, especially kids in eye clinics. I don't know if this is visible on camera, but I have a mark here from a cracker incident from a Diwali when I was 6 or 7 years old. Ideally, I want you to completely stop bursting crackers. It causes a lot of damage to the environment for just 5 minutes of fun. But I know that not a lot of people are going to change their minds. So let's at least see what we can do to keep ourselves safe and healthy. Just be aware that even the most innocent looking fireworks can explode. Yes, even those flower pots and even those chakras, the things that turn, can explode. If the chemicals and the gunpowder in the cracker don't work the way they are supposed to, they either just fizz out or they explode. So always treat all fireworks as explosives and always maintain a safe distance from all of the crackers. Also, don't put crackers inside coconut shells or tin cans. This is the most common way of injury that I see in the hospital because you can never predict how these pieces of coconut or tin cans are going to behave. They fly out as shrapnels and can hit people even at a long distance. And people who light crackers and then throw them, meet someone without a hand. They'll tell you how useful and important a hand is. Clothing made from synthetic materials and silk can easily catch fire. So God forbid, if a part of your clothing comes in contact with a firework, it can become a big fire quite fast. The solution? Simple. Wear either cotton dressing or jeans. These usually don't catch on fire very easily. Also, make sure you're not wearing any loose fitting clothes when you're bursting crackers. I know it's 2020 and you're supposed to be wearing a mask anyhow, but if you're someone with lung issues like asthma or COPD or someone who gets breathing difficulties during Diwali every year, wear a N95 respirator when people are bursting crackers outside, so especially in the evenings. N95 masks filter out 95% of the air we breathe, so you get to breathe much cleaner and fresher air. Here's a N95 mask that has been worn in Bangalore traffic. You can see it has turned a bit black. If this is the state of a mask worn in traffic, imagine how much pollution there'll be during Diwali. This might come as a shocker to a lot of people. They'll be like, it doesn't contain sugar, so it should be healthy, right? Wrong. Just because it doesn't contain sugar doesn't mean it's less in carbohydrates or fat. And if you didn't know, sugar is a form of carbohydrate. So instead of sugar, they add other substitutes like artificial sweeteners and sugar-like substances, which are not healthy. And on top of that, they have to add other substances to enhance the taste, because who would eat a sweet if it doesn't taste sweet and good? For example, there are around 53 calories in a regular Oreo and there are 45 calories in a sugar-free Oreo. As you can see, it's not a big difference. If I have to choose between regular sweets and sugarless sweets, I'd probably go for the regular one. So don't gobble up on sugar-free sweets thinking they are healthy. They may be more harmful than sugar-containing sweets. The only people sugar-free sweets are for people with diabetes. Yes, you read that right. The common thing that people do during Diwali is to close the windows and doors when people are bursting crackers outside. This would be a good idea if you close all the windows and doors before people start bursting crackers and you close all of them properly. But if there are any windows or ventilation shafts are open, you're making the situation much more worse. You see, the smoke that comes in from outside also needs to go out. Otherwise, the pollution inside the house becomes 2 times, 3 times, up to 10 times as worse as outdoors. So either open up all the windows and allow the smoke to pass through the house, or close all the windows, doors, ventilation shafts, everything properly. You don't want to be stuck in a middle ground situation here. We should be hopeful for the best, but should be prepared for the worst. Injuries are very common during Diwali, so having a first aid box will always be helpful. Your first aid kit will need bandages, sterile cotton pads, antiseptic and skin safe plasters like these. If any burn injuries happen, pour a lot of cold water on the burn and go and meet a doctor. Do not apply anything on the wound. People apply things like turmeric, talcum powder, etc., which just worsens the wound healing. Do not apply anything, just go meet a doctor. In addition to these tips, some common sense tips are to never let kids burst crackers on their own. Tell them what all different kinds of crackers do, whether they explode or not. Teach them how to stay safe and always store crackers away from the reach of kids. All that being said, I wish you a very happy Diwali. May this festival bring a lot of happiness to you and your family. And if you like this video, make sure you give it a big thumbs up and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. And make sure that you click the notification bell next to it so you get a notification whenever I upload a video. Stay safe and have a happy Diwali.